Marth got a freaking throw hands. You see this?
I was saying, Marth's got a sword. Sometimes, you know, notably, not the greatest track record against swords. However, right, the fact that you have to space things so perfectly, right, that Olimar can live so much longer against this character unless he, as long as Kirby knows the spacing, doesn't give X these opportunities and can control the zone of space, which he's doing very well early. You know, it could actually be very hard for X to find the openings to really take full advantage of the sword in this matchup.
Absolutely, and right now we're seeing X in a really precarious situation at 150%, almost getting that tipper, not getting it just entirely yet, but making up that damage in the difference, 87 to 85% right on the board, and almost gonna get something right there, but not entirely just yet. And X is 100% off stage, and this is something where we can see death on X's end.
Yeah, no, absolutely. However, it's gonna still be Kirby closing out the stock. It's just been so hard for X to pin him down, find these consistent hits. You see Kirby's ability to play under the platform here, right, defensively, forcing X to not be able to get these falling nairs, these forward airs to find his way in, right? Marth's favorite tools in neutral, because he just gonna get caught on the platform or up smash if he tries. And it's allowing Kirby to just focus on this zoning this horizontal space over and over, doing a fantastic job.
Mm-hmm. I really like this choice of Battlefield so that we can see, you know, X being able to escape pretty easily onto the top platform. But we're seeing X at 61% to 111%, and X needs to be something to be able to take off this set, and that's exactly what we're trying to see here. But Kirby just running away a lot right now, and this is not looking like great for X right now.
Yeah, X just hasn't been able to get away, just to find his way out of that zone of control, right, that Kirby is finding. And even when he gets put up high, even when he has the opportunity to maybe jump away, Kirby's taking full use of these platforms to get up there and find these juggles in a way that you don't really see all that often from Olimar. And that being said, you can't push those buttons on Marth's shield. Dolphin Slash, such a good out of shield move, and gonna close that stock out. At least get X on the board here so far.
Absolutely, and this is very, very unfair, I almost would say, on X. X is at 130%. Do you know where I feel like a lot of that damage come from? It came from, like, Pikmin.
Yeah,
but, like,
it just came from him not getting those Pikmin off him, right? They just kept pummeling him, giving him those little nibbles.
Absolutely, and that's the thing I feel like a little bit of an issue is for a lot of these characters, that we're seeing a lot of characters like Marth, like Bale, a lot of people who don't have the hitboxes to be able to take Olimar out.
That being said, he finally gets rid of that purple just before it flowered as well, so quite a resource loss from Kirby there, but he's able to find his way back, still caught on the platform, though this is a perfect opportunity for extra rack on percent. But somehow Kirby weaving his way in and out of the corner, finding ways to refill his Pikmin lineup, forcing X to back off, reset to neutral, and take full advantage of these platforms for movement, just trying to find a way in.
Absolutely, and right now, look at them Pikmin, them Pikmin's latching on, they're not gonna let you go. But we are seeing, you know, X trying his best to be able to get in right now. It's not working out too well, but we are gonna get a really nice 80%, 86% on the board right now. Not gonna do too much, especially since, you know, Kirby was able to get out of that pretty, you know, scot-free with down B. But, you know, this is still scary because X can die in a matter of seconds right now, especially since Purple Pikmin is on board.
And attempting to whistle, but the slight delay from X gonna find him at least a hit. However, gonna miss the tech. Not ready for the mix-up of Kirby's own, and he just can't miss those against players at this level, and unfortunately for X, it's gonna cost him the first game, with something that looked out of reach for most of it, but he really played himself right back into it at the end there.
Absolutely, and this was just really good on Kirby's end. I really like the way that they were playing around a lot of what X was doing. It just was really hard for X to be able to get anything on board, and because those Pikmins are on you, it actually makes it a lot harder to be able to get your moves out in the way that you intend them to, because of the, you know, hitboxes most of the time.
Yep, and we're finally seeing in X start to find some of these fares, relying on Dolphin Slash a little bit more early, but it's not gonna matter. He's got that purple on him. Can't get it off because he got caught in a juggle for so long, and that's going to be 76%, Jazzy. That's huge for Kirby early.
Absolutely, and I really feel like we need to see a little bit more grounded neutral coming in from X, because a lot of the times, X is getting hit by a lot of these, you know, Pikmin, and it's not going to be end up working too well if Kirby is not only going to be throwing Pikmin, but also stuffing out a lot of what X wants to use in neutral.
Yep, and right again, right, you see that Kirby is baiting out these fairs and whiff punishing by throwing these Pikmin, catching in X at end lag, allowing him to get a little bit more damage racked on, and it's just causing X at this point to get a little antsy. You see the way he's pressing preemptive buttons, allowing Kirby to call him out, and now with double purples online, it's starting to get scary.
Absolutely. No, so we are at, again, a similar position to, you know, the previous game, where we are a stock ahead on Kirby's end, and we're just seeing a little bit of the same issue, you know, again, with when it comes to F, just be having a little bit of a hard playing neutral and getting that F up tilt, getting stopped out right there. And now we're in a very bad situation on edge. Yep. What is XA going to be able to do?
I mean, he has to be able to find, you know, he has to close out this stock quick, right? If he goes down 3-1, I think the way, even as much as he brought that first game back, mentally, you can't, it's just so hard, especially with those two flower purples, right? Gonna lose his stock. Kerb making the adjustment, calling out that up smash this far away from stage. He has to throw those Pikmin away just to get light enough to get back. So the at least you got rid of the double purple, but the result was a white blue purple. Oh, the best lineup for low percent, and now we've seen the red in there, you know, maybe the second best, and this is just so hard for X to deal with so far.
Absolutely. Well, we are two stocks down and only 120%. Again, this is really a lot of what we were seeing in the first game, but magnified due to a lot of what was happening on X's end, just not being able to position himself well and being able to get those hits that he really needs to. Marth is a character that really relies on him being able to position himself properly, get those nice fairs, use those jumps very sparingly when he needs to, and being able to get those hippers. But that is going to be a three stock on Kirby, and or just, from Kirby.
It's so unfortunate that both those games ended in missed techs.
Mm-hmm.
And it wasn't even that they were untechable, it was just that X just wasn't ready for it. And it kind of felt like at the end of those games, his mental kind of just started to run out a little bit. You saw him start to get a little bit antsy.
Mm-hmm.
Right, we see the again, right, these preemptive options getting called out there again, right? Kirby fading it back with a Pikmin throw and then catching the end lag of that option with the fair to close it out this time as well, right? Dashing back, calling out that Dolphin Slash and finding another stock. Just such good stuff from Kerb here. Always just one step ahead.
Absolutely. And that is going to be where we end this setup. And unfortunately, where we end our block here. So that means we're going to be leaving you guys. No, like, I'm not leaving this time. Like, I'm not lying. But no, like, literally, no, like, literally,
Jazzy.
Like, no, I literally, did I tell you, like, has anyone told you how awesome you are, right? No, like,
has anyone told you how awesome you are?
No, like, I tell myself that I'm awesome, like, every second of the day, so, like,
yeah, but
honestly.
I'm telling you.
No, like, awesome. So, like, you're the first person to tell me that today, you know, and I love that for you. No, it's literally, I love this for us. Don't you love this for us?
I love this for us, but I love it even more for all the people who get to see the amazing next group of casters we have coming up for you. But, Jazzy, before we go, where can they find you?
Where can they find me? Oh, my God. You see this thing right here? Oh, my God. That's me. Hi, I'm trying to... Yeah, right here. Jazzy G. That's me. Hi, Jazzy Tremosin. The Bayonetta connoisseur, the literally everything you need to know about Bayo. I got you. No, if you, like, think I'm awesome and think I'm kind of, like, cool and quirky, you should, like, follow me because I'm, like, really nice and I like being there. And, like, bestie. No, like, where can they find you? Like,
well,
no, like...
you can follow me. Find me also down below at RitualSSB on Twitter.
Yeah.
But you're going to have to find me there because... they're getting ready to start the next set, and we don't want to keep them waiting, so we're going to have to get out of here.
No,
see y'all
you're
next
literally
time.
Right. Bye!